Good day, students. Welcome to math.serve.com. In this clip, we're going to be going over two examples on how to calculate the average rate of change and the instantaneous rate of change. Okay, so before we get started, let's take a look at the formulas real quick. The first formula we're going to be looking at is the average rate of change. I'm going to call it AROC. The average rate of change on an interval AB is also known as the slope of the secant line. Okay, so average rate of change is delta F over delta X. Okay, it can be calculated by computing F of B minus F of A divided by B minus A. This is an advanced method of writing your typical slope formula, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, the rise over rise. Okay, now let's take a look at the instantaneous rate of change formula. I'm going to call this IROC. Now, instantaneous rate of change is at a specific point, a specific x value. All right, average rate of change is on an interval, you need two x values. Instantaneous, you need just one value, namely x equals a, okay? And that is df dx. So if you know your differentiation rules, you can instantly compute df dx, or you can compute the instantaneous rate of change at using the limit formula, limit definition of the derivative, limit as h approaches 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x over h. Alright, now two things you want to keep in mind. When you're thinking about average rate of change, think about the secant line. Alright, the secant line through two points. And then for the instantaneous rate of change, you want to think about the tangent line. Okay? So these are the graphical representations of these two values we're computing. All right. So let's take a look at an example. Example number one. The instructions are provided here. We're to find the average rate of change over the given interval, and then we have to compute the instantaneous rate of change of the left boundary. Or we can say at the left boundary, okay? So let's start with the A part, with question one. What if we have the function f of x equals 2x squared plus 2x plus 1 on the interval 0 to 1 half, okay? 0 to 1 half. So the lower bound is a, and the upper bound is b. So this is our a, and this is our b. All right. So the a part, we have to compute the average rate of change of this function of f of x on the interval 0 to 1/2. We know what the formula is for computing the average rate of change, so let's go ahead and write it down. So AROC, average rate of change, on the interval 0 to 1 half. Remember, this is not a point. This is an interval, okay? That is given by f of b, which is f of 1 half, minus f of a, f of 0, divided by b minus a, all right? So let's find out what these values are. So let's rewrite it, f of a, which is f of 1/2. Actually, that's f of b. Let's make that real quick correction there. So this is f of b, which is f of 1/2. Now, how do we do that? We simply input 1/2 into the function, okay? So we have 2 times 1/2 squared plus 2 times 1/2 plus 1. Okay, 1/2 square is 1/4 times 2 is 1/2 plus 2 times 1/2 is 1 plus 1. Okay, so this gives us 5 over 2. Now f of a, the value of the function at the left endpoint, f of 0, is simply going to be 2 times 0 squared plus 2 times 0 plus 1. And you can clearly see that you have 0 plus 0 plus 1, which equals 1. Now we have everything we need. Let's go ahead and compute what the average rate of change is. So average rate of change on the interval 0 to 1 half is given by f of 1 half, which is 5 over 2 minus 1 divided by 1 half minus 0. Okay, so 5 over 2 minus 1 is the same thing as 2 and a half minus 1. Which is, well, we can just write this as a fraction, times this by 2, top and bottom. So 5 minus 2 is 3 over 2, divided by 1 half. And we have 3 over 2 times, multiply the numerator by the reciprocal of the denominator, which is 2 over 1, right? And then the 2's divide out, and your final answer is 3. So let's write down what our answer is. The average rate of change of f on 0, 1 half is equal to 3. Alright? Okay, now the B part, we have to compute the instantaneous rate of change. Okay, the instantaneous rate of change. So the IROC, instantaneous rate of change, at x equals a, is basically the derivative df dx evaluated at x equals a. So we're looking at df dx, and we're evaluating that at x equals a. That's your instantaneous rate of change, all right? So that's the formula we have up there. All right, so this involves the use of some tools from calculus to find the derivative first, and then we'll evaluate it at x equals a, all right? So let's go ahead and do that. We know what f of x is. Let's rewrite it. F of x is 2x squared plus 2x plus 1. So df dx is basically the derivative. So let's find the derivative of this function using term-by-term differentiation. If we apply the constant multiple rule and the power rule to 2x squared, we'll have 2 times the derivative of x squared is 2x, plus the derivative of 2x is simply 2 times x to the 0, which is just 1. And then the derivative of 1 is 0. So the derivative, df dx, 4x is going to be 4x plus 2. This helps us calculate the instantaneous rate of change at any x value in the domain of this function. But we are asked to compute the instantaneous rate of change at the left boundary. Okay, so we're looking for the instantaneous rate of change at 0, which is the left boundary. So we're looking for df dx at x equals 0. Another way to write this, if you don't like this notation, is f prime of 0. All right, how do you compute f prime of 0? You simply plug in 0 into the derivative, 4 times 0 plus 2. And your final answer is 2. All right, so let's go ahead and write down the meaning, the instantaneous rate of change. The instantaneous spell that correctly. Instantaneous rate of change of f of x at x equals 0 is 2. Okay, so there you have it. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. We really appreciate it. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for updates to other cool tutorials such as this. And do post a comment in the comment section if you have any questions about this presentation. Thanks again for watching. Have a wonderful day.